Dear students, in this video, I will tell about how to run XML code with CSS coding on web browser to see a formatted way of XML code. So we start with this XML, a brief description. It stands for extensible markup language, and it is designed to store and transport data. XML was designed to both human and machine readable mode, and it is used to exchange data. So all these points tells us that XML is not having any tag which can use to show a formatted web page. Its basic purpose is to store and transport and exchange the data. Writing XML code. So these are some points which you need to take care while writing XML code. XML is case sensitive, that means capital letter and small letters are different. There is only one root element and there are no predefined tags like you have in HTML. There are only container tags, no empty element available. Tags can be nested under parents following the rules of well-defined document. It means you have to close the tag which you are nesting under any parent tag before the parent tag closing. Attributes are enclosed in quotes, but values are written without quotes. You should follow variable naming rules, like you cannot use any special character except you can use underscore. Like you can write roll underscore number, but you cannot write roll space number or roll number full stop. You cannot start with a digit or any special character. Save the file with .xml extension and you write the code in Notepad or any simple text editor. On writing XML code, there is a separate video in the playlist that you can see and learn how to write XML code. Title, country, company price are the field names, and this is the data. Three records of a table are shown for which you have to write XML code. In this video also, I am explaining the practical way of writing XML and CSS code. This is example of CSS code where we are writing the first line XML version 1.0 and encoding for the browser. CD store is the root tag, root element, and there are, in this example, I have shown the tagging of only two records, CD slash CD. CD is the parent tag of title, country, company, and price. Here, we have changed the values inside the attributes. Learning XML is the value for title tag. Now, the purpose of this video is to run XML code on browser as per the desired format. The XML code will remain same, only you need to add one more line, that is text upon CSS and the CSS file. The purpose of writing this line is that in XML we are using style sheet where type is of CSS file and reference is to this CSS, like test.css. Here you will write your CSS file name which you have created using Notepad or any simple text editor. Always remember, both the files should be in a common folder and same folder, otherwise you need to put the path. In the CSS file, we write the formatting options in the way of writing attribute with values. CD store is the root element, background color, colon. Here, if you note, colon is before the value of attribute and every line is ending with a semicolon. Here, you are writing display block. Display block means every record will come in the next line. Top margin or bottom margin you can set accordingly with points. Similarly, you can set the font size, color of the font, and display block again, it will come in the next line. If you want to give same formatting for different tags of your XML file, you can separate this by comma. Now this is the code which we have discussed for demo.xml. You have to take care of one point, that your XML and CSS file should be in one folder. And same, I have explained, here I am displaying three records as I have displayed in the discussion. Then you have test.css file. Here I have changed some attributes and you will see how the browser display will work when you run the XML file. So this is our XML file in the browser. If you are not using CSS, then your file will look differently. That I'll show you how it will look. So if you see, if you are not using CSS file, it will look like this. So all the tags are displayed. This is root element and other records. That means there are three records that will be displayed in the browser. But if you want formatted one, then you have to use CSS file. So if in my CSS file, if I change the color options, say in place of cyan, I can put white color and save it and then refresh it. So you will see these things, this color is changed. So now you have learned how to connect one XML code with a CSS file. This is a practice time. Here you can write XML code for these two records, where movie name, rating, year and collection are the field names. Hopefully you will write a good code. All the best. Thank you so much. Students, if you have liked the video and find it very useful, subscribe to my channel, press like and share button, and also press the bell icon to never miss the useful updates. All the best.